Well, anytime you're dealing with a water issue, you're likely to find Carol Baker's name come to play in the Texas Water Foundation, who she's the executive director for, really has done, I guess I would say it's unusual, but it's something we learned to expect from Carol Baker. She's put together a great tour, many stops along this the way, and she's done it so in a way that basically helps to paint a picture of the challenges that we're facing. We're focused this time on a lot of the subsidence issues, but also looking at the water treatment and water distribution issues. And so this tour has been a great opportunity for a lot of decision makers or some elected officials along the way and other people that are involved in various parts of water quality and quantity issues. And this tour is helping to let us firsthand see some of the challenges that we're facing, but also some of the solutions that are in place. And it's also good, I think, for us to have opportunity for the interaction and the chance to meet face-to-face and discuss some of these issues, I think, will be helpful as we move forward, especially as we come into a legislative session.
Today we're at the WaterWorks Education Center, and we're going to find out about all of the good conservation efforts that are going on and the educational opportunities that are available to the citizens of this region. And mainly, we're showing, putting the light on all of the good things that are going on in this area and showing policymakers what our needs are down here in the Houston area as well. We have to have an acute awareness of how water is involved in our everyday life and how precious that resource is and how necessary it is for us to respect the natural resource and to preserve and conserve it as best we can.
I think the bus tour is great because it gives all of us, even those of us who know a lot about water, more of a hands-on experience to be able to actually see water treatment plants, wastewater treatment plants, nature areas that are impacted by water, marsh areas and wetlands that are important to wildlife and fish. All these things really are part of our whole water system, and it's a good thing to be able to see them in person through the bus tour. I think the City of Houston's Water Education Center is a great way, especially to be able to bring school children and others and educate them about the whole water treatment process and all the water issues that we deal with on a daily basis. It gives kids especially, I think, an opportunity to understand the process better of how water is acquired and treated and disposed of, and that can make them better water citizens.
The WaterWorks Education Center opened in October 2010, and we are available. It's free of charge for any school groups, adult groups, individuals who'd like to come out and learn about their drinking water resources and how to protect our water.
One of the things that we promote is water conservation, and water conservation brings stewardship. We really want the children to learn at a young age, but of course we want anyone, adults, seniors, anyone, to come out, learn about water conservation, learn about water education.
Not only can they come here, but if a school can't come to us, we can always go to them. We do classroom presentations, we've done auditorium presentations, or just a booth at one of their science fairs.
WaterWorks, as an extension of our previously one day event, special event about water, and now we have five special events, usually about 300 to 400 kids a day.
Well, WaterWorks Education Center received a grant this spring to create a vegetable garden, a home garden from Burpee Home Gardens. We were one of six in the nation. It's very important to conserve water outdoors because our water consumption generally goes up about 50% in the summer months because of outdoor watering. And we're washing cars, we're, you know, using water for playing and recreation. So if people learn to use it efficiently, they can use what they need but not waste it.
WATRnews.com.